Hey guys, and welcome back. So in this little tutorial that you're seeing right now is an app that is demonstrating how YOLO version 4 can be used for social distancing monitoring. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can implement your own social distancing app using YOLO version 4. So how the app works is that after we perform detections with YOLO version 4, we calculate the Euclidean distance between all detected boxes and filter out or flag the people that are closest to each other, indicating that they are at risk. So before we get into the tutorial, let's take a look at our roadmap. That one, we spent setting up our prerequisites. That two, we installed darknet and implemented YOLO version 4 on images and video. That three, I explained the darknet output code for video and webcam execution. That four, which is this one, where we'll be creating a social distancing app. Ensure that you have completed the previous tutorials before attempting this one. Okay, so let's get right into the tutorial. Another thing, please don't forget to watch right till the end to find out how you can win one of 20 free enrollments to the course of your choice, including this one. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions on future videos. Subscribe so you get notified when the next AI/AR tutorial is out. And feel free to share this video with any of your friends if you think it may be helpful. So let's get right into it and roll intro. So the full YOLO version 4 course will be available as a comprehensive course on augmentedstartups.com. I'm pretty excited for it because we're going to be covering a lot. From execution of a pre-trained model on images, videos and webcam, labeling a new dataset in YOLO version 4 format, creating a custom dataset from other datasets but in YOLO version 4 format, and then we train our own custom detector natively on your PC. We also implement on a multi-GPU and develop some real applications. We also go into how you can create nice PyQt user interface for object detection using YOLO version 4. I really hope that you are excited by this course as I am, because if you are, then you can enroll down below. Remember that I'll not be publishing this course anywhere else and it will be exclusive to augmentedstartups.com. Okay, so if you're ready to get started with AI, computer vision and YOLO version 4, click the link down below and let's get started. Social distancing monitoring app. Okay, so first go to my GitHub repo. github.com, augmented startups, YOLO version 4, tutorials. Just note that I've updated my GitHub from rangegt09 to augmented startups. So if the previous link didn't work, it's because of this update. So moving on. We're going to be working with app 1, social distancing app. While we glance at it, click to clone or download the code. So over here we have two files. They're both the same file, except one is the base script, in which we'll code the basic functionality of the social distancing app together within this tutorial. However, if you want to skip the coding, then you can just download and run this file. If you do, then the tutorial will explain how the app was coded. We've also heavily commented the lines of interest for reference. Coding. Okay, so once again, you've downloaded and opened up the base code. You'll see four sections that we'll need to code in order to get our social distancing monitoring app to run. The rest of the code was explained in the previous video, Euclidean distance code. So let's get into the first section and then populate the functions that calculate the Euclidean distance between two points. It's very simple. Distance or DSD equals mat.squareroot 0.1 squared plus 0.2 squared. So DSD or distance equals the square root of the sum of the squared points. And we return our distance or DSD. Next we have our convert back function that we've seen in the previous tutorials. And this converts our center detection coordinates into rectangle coordinates. I shall explain this in a later part of this tutorial. cvDrawboxes code. Okay, so this is where the meat of the code will be. There are three submodules, each with different goals. We are going to start off with the first one, which is 3.1. 3.1 person filter. Let's type in if len or length of the detections is greater than 0. So if we have at least one detection in the image. So this essentially checks for detection presence within a frame. Centroid underscore dict equals dict brackets. So if the above condition was met, then we create a dictionary and we call it centroid underscore dict. Object ID equals 0. So this is, we initialize a variable called object ID and set it to 0. for detections in detections. In this if statement, we filter out all the detections for persons or people only. Name underscore tag equals string detection 0.decode. So this checks for only the person tag of the cocoa file, which has strings of all the names. And if name underscore tag equals person, so this says that if the tag is a person, then we get the coordinates of the detection. So x, y, w, h equals detections 2, 0, detections 2, 1, detections 2, 2, then detections 2, 3. So what this does is that it stores all the center points of the detections. So x min, y min, x max, y max equals convert back float x, float y, float w, and float h. Now remember we spoke about the convert back function, which converts from center coordinates to rectangular coordinates. We also use floats to ensure the precision of the bounding box. And now we append the center point of the bounding box for all the people detected. Centroid underscore dict square brackets object id equals int x, int y, x min, y min, x max, and y max. This creates a dictionary of tuples with object id as the index center points and bounding box. So we're going to go back to the convert back function. And if you visualize a bounding box, we normally have our center point with the coordinates x, y, with a width of w and height of h. Now we pass it through the function, where we want to obtain the rectangular coordinates x min, y max, y min, and y max. It'll make it easier to enter in the parameters for drawing a rectangle for a bounding box. 3.2, social distancing criteria. Okay, so next up we're going to be creating two lists, red zone list and red line list. So these are the lists containing the object IDs that is under the threshold distance condition. So for ID 1.1, ID 2, P2 or 0.2, in combination centroid underscore dict dot items brackets 2. So this gets all the combinations for close detections. So it looks at the list of multiple items, ID 1 and ID 2, which are the index, and P1 and P2 are points 1 and 2. Dx dy equals 0.1 index 0 minus P2 index 0, and P1 index 1 minus P2 index 1. So this checks for the difference between the centroid x is 0 and y denotes 1. Distance equals is close dx, dy. Remember earlier we saw the isClose definition? Well, here we call the function to calculate the Euclidean distance. So if distance is smaller than 75.0, so this sets our social distance threshold to a constant. If they meet the condition, then if ID1 is not in red zone list, then we say red zone list.append ID1, and this adds the ID to a list. And then we have red underscore line underscore list dot append, and then we add 0.1 square brackets 0 to 2. So this adds our points to the list. And then we do the same for ID2 in red zone list. Here we have red zone list dot append ID2, red line list dot append 0.2 square brackets 0 to 2. In the last section for this module, for IDX box in centroid underscore dict dot items brackets. So here we search within the dictionary with respect to the index, which is the key, and box is the value. If IDX is in red zone list, so if the index is in red zone list, then cv2 dot rectangle. We put in our image, box 2, box 3, comma, box 4, box 5. And then we set our color to red, which is 255,00, and with our point size of 2. Else, we create another rectangle, but we make it green. And here we have our color, which is in RGB, which says 0255,00, which denotes our green color. 3.3, risk indication. In this final module, we indicate how many people are at risk. So ticks equals people at risk, percentage s, percentage string length, red zone list. So this basically counts people at risk. We want to put the location of this text at 10,25, which, as I mentioned, sets the location of the displayed text. And then we have cv2.putText, img, which is our image text that we specified above, at the location that we specified above as well. cv2.font, this is the font that we want to use, 1,255.0.0, as is red, 2, cv2.line_aa. And essentially this entire line just displays the text in red. For check range, 0, length or length of the red line list minus 1. So here we tell the app to draw the lines between the nearby bounding boxes and iterate through the red line items. So we have our start point equals red line list, check, and endpoint which equals red line list check plus 1. Then we have check underscore line underscore x, which equals the absolute value of the endpoint at index 0 and the starting point index 0. And here we calculate the line coordinates of x. Then we do the same, check line y equals the absolute value of endpoint 1 minus start point 1. And again, we calculate the line coordinates but for y. If check line x is smaller than 75, which is the threshold that we specified above, and check line y is smaller than 25. So this is our if statement that checks if the lines are below our threshold distance. Next we have cv2.line, image, start point, end point, our color which is red, and our thickness of 2. So if the above statement is true, then only the lines below the threshold are displayed. Okay, so if everything was typed out correctly, then you can go ahead and run the app. Open up command prompt. Make sure that you have a bunch of test videos, which you can get from the net, or if you prefer, you can use your webcam. Type in Python app1 underscore social underscore distance dot py. If you are using the base file, then just add underscore base to it. If you want to change your input video, then you can change it right over here. Ensure that your input directory matches the directory of your video, and then run it again. So using a GTX 1080, I'm getting more or less an average frame rate of 18 FPS. If you got this working, post a link down below to your video or image of social distancing working in action. Let's take a look at our roadmap. That one, we spent setting up our prerequisites. That two, we installed darknet and implemented YOLOv4 on images and video. That 3, I explained the darknet output code for video and webcam execution. That 4, which is this one, where we will be creating a social distancing app. Dataset labeling and developing custom YOLOv4 object detector and training will be part of my YOLOv4 course. I'll have the link to that down below. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions on future videos. Subscribe so you get notified when the next AI/AR tutorial is out. And feel free to share this video with any of your friends if you think it may be helpful. Okay, so earlier I mentioned that if you're interested in winning one of 20 free enrollments to any of the Augmented Startups courses, then all you have to do is like and comment on this video and sign up at the link down below. Winners will be announced every 3 months. You can comment on anything or provide suggestions on upcoming videos and ideas as I've mentioned earlier. So the full YOLOv4 course will be available as a comprehensive course on augmentedstartups.com. I'm pretty excited for it because we're going to be covering a lot, from execution of a pre-trained model on images, videos, and webcam, labeling a new dataset in YOLOv4 format, creating a custom dataset from other datasets but in YOLOv4 format, and then we train our own custom detector natively on your PC. We also implement on a multi-GPU and develop some real applications. We also go into how you can create nice PyQt user interface for object detection using YOLOv4. I really hope that you are excited by this course as I am, because if you are, then you can enroll down below. Remember that I'll not be publishing this course anywhere else and it will be exclusive to augmentedstartups.com. Also check out Geekyb AI, who are expert developers in AI, computer vision, and deep learning. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next lecture.